Welcome to the Controlled Environment Agriculture, or CEA, Aquaponics Greenhouse of the Aquaculture Center at Morrisville State College. This greenhouse is a demonstration project in which we grow fish and plants together, recycling the water through the system so that the plants can use the nutrients released from the fish and can, in doing so, condition the water so that it can be returned to the fish system. Our aquaponics system contains a total of 4,500 gallons of water. This includes three fish tanks, totaling approximately 2,000 gallons of growing space, along with five small nursery tanks. The rest of the water is in our plant and filter components. There is one raft and pond or deep flow technique system, and one NFT or nutrient film technique system, in which we grow a variety of lettuces and herbs, tomatoes, cucumbers, peppers, and strawberries. We have the ability to operate these systems together or separately. In this CEA system, we are able to use well water, tap water, or reuse wastewater from our cold water facility. In the fish portion of the aquaponics greenhouse, we raise tilapia because it is a fish that is easy to grow, tolerant of a wide variety of conditions, and does well at temperatures that the plants require. There are separate tanks so that as the fish grow, they can be separated into groups of similar size. About once a month, the fish are sampled. This means that a small percentage of the group of fish are weighed and measured in order to find the average weight and length of all the fish. This tells us how the food should be changed in amount and pellet size, how fast the fish are growing so that we can project when they will be ready to go to market, and if they need to be sorted by size so that the smaller fish have an opportunity to grow without competing with larger fish for food and space. The tilapia are sold live every few weeks to a market in Syracuse, but have also been sold to our own restaurant, the Copper Turret, other nearby restaurants, or directly to people in the community. In this system, it currently takes about 9 months to get the tilapia from a 1 gram fry to a 1 to 1.5 pound marketable fish. When the water leaves the fish system, it moves to our mechanical filtration, where heavy solids are settled out and removed by filter screens. From there, it passes through two bead filters that remove finer solids. The water then passes through a UV sterilizer and on to the low space bioreactor, or LSB, where nitrifying bacteria convert the ammonia from the fish to nitrite, then to nitrate. Plants prefer this form of nitrogen. The water moves from the bioreactor onto the plant systems or back to the fish tanks. The process of growing the plants in our greenhouse begins with us planting seeds in rock wool. Once the seedlings have sprouted, they are transplanted into floating foam rafts of the pond system or the troughs of the NFT system. The spacing of the seedlings in the rafts is 3 inches. The roots of the plants grow down into the water, which is 12 inches deep. The plants will grow in these rafts for about 3 weeks, and then they are transplanted into other rafts with 6-inch spacing, where they will grow until harvest. Although there is a constant flow of water, it is aerated to ensure that the roots have enough oxygen. In the NFT system, there is a constant flow of nutrient-rich water in a thin film over the roots. The plants are treated similarly as they are in the pond system, but the spacing of the plants in the troughs are 2 inches to start and then 8 inches until harvest. Under optimum conditions, 1,000 heads of lettuce can be produced weekly. Biosecurity is very important to us and to the health of fish and plants. Anytime the plants are handled, gloves are worn to prevent transferring bacteria to the plants. Scissors and the table used to harvest the plants are all disinfected between uses. Produce from this greenhouse goes to our dining hall and restaurant, other local restaurants, sold at farmers markets through Morrisville Fresh, a student-run LLC and part of the agricultural business program, or donated to food pantries. The entire system is monitored and controlled by the Source Sentinel system, developed by the engineering firm O'Brien & Gear of Syracuse. Heat, humidity, and water quality are all monitored. Supplemental light is provided from LED or high-pressure sodium lights. Fans circulate the air in the greenhouse. The plants are cooled by an evaporative cooler. Water circulates over the cardboard of the cooler, and as air is pulled across the damp cardboard, the water evaporates, cooling the air in the greenhouse up to 10 degrees Fahrenheit cooler than the outside air. The shade curtain prevents the greenhouse from heating up too much in the warm weather and from losing heat in the cool weather, reducing heating costs by up to 30%. The greenhouse is heated by two fuel oil burners, one of which runs on biodiesel, made on campus in the college's renewable energy program. The fish tanks help moderate the temperature by being a large thermal mass that gives off heat at night. Carbon dioxide, oxygen, temperature, light, total organic carbon, and ammonia can all be monitored by this source sentinel unit. For educational purposes, the students use other methods of water quality testing. The shade curtain, fans, water, and lights can all be adjusted remotely. This technology gives us the ability to improve growth and to get the most out of our production. Even without this technology, CEA Aquaponics offers anyone from the home gardener to the commercial farmer, in the city or the country, the opportunity to grow more food in less space, using less water, fertilizers, and pesticides. There is less pollution and runoff than traditional agriculture, and it can produce fresh local fish and vegetables year-round.